I wanted a non-arbitrary way of determining the distance between vanishing points. Now I know. Use the cone of vision. What is the cone of vision? I'll demonstrate what it can do and then explain. Here's my frame. This is the eye level. I'm going to put the horizon line in the same place, the middle. This X on the left is my left vanishing point. I can rotate this blue right angle to intersect with that X. And where the other side of the right angle crosses the horizon line, that's where my right vanishing point goes. Here is a 3D scene with the cone of vision in action. As the camera pans around, notice how the right angle keeps up with the X's. Magical. The cone of vision represents the human eye's field of view, minus peripheral vision. The angle is 60 degrees. The cone starts in between our eyes. This is the station point. If we're using a camera, the station point is the camera's aperture, or sensor. When things go outside of the cone of vision, they appear distorted. To make your very own cone of vision, start with a circle. The eye level, or EL, goes horizontally through the center. The center of vision, or CV, goes vertically through the center. This is the center of vision point, or CVP. Put a 60 degree angle on the center of vision, 30 degrees on either side of the line, and move it so the rays pass through the intersections of the eye level and the circle. The vertex of this angle is the station point, or SP. A right angle, 90 degrees, is placed at the station point. It's what we use to figure out how far apart our vanishing points are. The center of vision point matches the center of our frame. Now we pick a focal length. If we're using a long lens, our frame is tiny. If we're using a wide lens, it can extend beyond the circle. To find different lens lengths, I use this guide. These frames represent the field of view of lenses on a 35mm SLR or full-frame DSLR camera. My favorite lens is a 35mm. Let's put the cone of vision to use again. My camera is pointed straight ahead, parallel to the ground, so my horizon line is in the middle of the frame, overlapping the eye level. I want to draw a box with one face going this way. That would put my left vanishing point here. I line up the left side of the blue right angle to the left vanishing point, and where the right side crosses the eye level, that's where we put the right vanishing point. And there's a box. When the camera is pointed straight ahead, the horizon line is in the middle. When the camera tilts up, the horizon line goes down. If the camera tilts down, the horizon line goes up. As we tilt, notice how the vanishing points spread out a bit. But it doesn't change that much until we tilt enough that the horizon line gets into the bottom or top third of the frame. By that point, you'll want to use three-point perspective, which I'll discuss later. If you want to move the horizon line within that middle third and you don't want to complicate things and you're alright with being close to accurate, you can move the cone of vision stuff up or down. Or think of it as moving the frame up or down. Here's an example. I want my horizon line to be down here and the right vanishing point to be here. I pull in my cone of vision stuff and match up my chosen lens guide to the frame. Scoot that cone of vision group so that the eye level matches the horizon line. I rotate that right angle so it intersects with my right vanishing point. Mark where the other side of the 90 degree angle crosses the horizon line. That's about where the left vanishing point is. Here's a 3D scene to show you how it should be. The vanishing point should be a little bit further because the camera is tilted up, but it's pretty close. Way better than guessing. And there's the box. In three-point perspective, how do you figure out where to put the vertical vanishing point? Place your horizon line. Rotate the cone of vision 90 degrees. Rotate the right angle so one side passes through the intersection of the center of vision and the horizon line. Where the other side of the right angle crosses the center of vision, that is your vertical vanishing point. I'm going to hide the green and blue lines. Now imagine we know where we want to put the left vanishing point. Here. Where do we put the right vanishing point? We grab a giant T. The stem runs through the center of vision point to the vanishing point we established. Slide the T until the crossbar intersects with the vertical vanishing point. Where the other side of the crossbar intersects with the horizon line, that's where the right vanishing point goes. And there's the box.